So let us verify the series combination of two resistors. For this, I have taken two resistor coils, then one multimeter. So with this multimeter, we can directly measure the resistance of this resistance coil. So first, let us see what is the resistance of the first coil. You can notice that the value of the first resistance coil is 20.7. Now let me connect the second coil. Which shows 20.7 again. Now let's connect these two in series. In theory, we have already studied series combination means one resistor is to be connected after the other resistance. So here, this is the first resistance and that is connected in series with the second resistance. Now, if you observe the reading in the multimeter, it is 40.8. So, when R1 and R2 are connected in series, must be R1 plus R2. So, we have obtained R1 as 20.7 and R2 as also 20.7. When we add these two, it should have been 41.4. Instead, we are getting 40.7. So, within the limitations of this instruments, we are able to prove that R1 plus R2 is equal to the net resistance. Now, the same thing can be used to find out the parallel combination. So in parallel combination, we have to connect one resistance and the second resistance is also connected between the same two terminals. So here, so this is parallel combination. So in this parallel combination, 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 is the formula. So when we write 1 by 20.7 plus 1 by 20.7, it will be 2 by 20.7. So it is roughly 10.35 we should get, but we are getting here 10.7. So more or less the, as I told you, within the limitations of this apparatus, we have proved that the laws of combination of resistors connected in series and parallel.